I am Indy Neidell, and this is another exciting episode of Out of the Trenches, where I sit here in this chair of wisdom and answer your questions about the First World War. All right, what happened to Togoland in World War I? Okay. Togoland, if you don't know, was a German colony in Africa going into the war. It's the region of Africa that now, together with the former Gold Coast, is Ghana and Togo. Anyhow, back then it had a population of around 1 million people and had been a German protectorate for 30 years. But when the war began, there were no German army units in Togoland, just some paramilitary police and some colonists with military training. Still, Togoland saw action pretty much from the very beginning of the war. In fact, shortly after Britain declared war on Germany, the Allies cut the undersea cable from Monrovia to Tenerife, so the radio station at Kamina in Togoland was suddenly the only means of communication between the colony and Germany. The acting governor of the colony wired to neighboring Gold Coast, a British colony, proposing neutrality, but London refused, and the Allies demanded that the colony surrender. A similar proposal to also neighboring French Dahomey was met with an invasion, right? French police occupied customs posts already August 6th, and the British invasion began the next day. This is August 1914 I'm talking about, the very beginning of the war. Lomé, the capital, was occupied on the 9th, and then the Allies began the advance to Kamina to seize the radio stuff. French and Germans clashed the 13th at the Battle of Bafilo, and the French were pushed back. But a couple of days later, French and British forces ambushed and beat the Germans at the Battle of Agbelovhoe, right? The Battle of Kra was the real final battle, where the Germans made a stand at the Kra River. The British attacked on the 22nd, taking pretty heavy casualties while being repulsed. And actually, Lieutenant George Thompson became the first British officer killed in the entire war at that battle. The next day, the British found that the Germans had abandoned their trenches. They had withdrawn to the wireless station to destroy the 9 radio towers and all the electrical equipment. They managed this before the Allies arrived, but they surrendered the colony to the British. The Togoland campaign was the first military operations by the British of the war. So let's see, in 1916, the colony was partitioned into French and British zones, and after the war, British and French Togoland were eventually created under the League of Nations. They would exist for decades. In Russia, we have the Reds and the Whites now. Now? Okay. All right. I also heard about Black and Green. Who were they? Oh, okay. All right. Hey, guess what, Flo? Guess what?
What?
Okay. I get to talk about Nestor Makhno. Okay, Nestor Makhno is one of the most interesting characters of the whole war and post-war period. He was the leader of the Revolutionary Insurrection Army of Ukraine, an anarchist army known as the Black Army. Now, they were active during the Russian Civil War and the Ukrainian Revolution. During the Civil War, there were loads of anarchist bands that fought in Ukraine against both the red and white Russian forces. Makhno and his forces began operations already in the summer of 1918 in southeast Ukraine. He was fighting then against the Hetmanate government installed by the German military. And the Black Army was formed in September. Now, it was set up like a normal army, not like just a bandit organization. It had infantry, cavalry, and artillery divisions, you know? I don't really have time to go into much detail here, but they really grew in size after the Red Army mutinies of 1919. Many of the mutineers joined the Blacks, who at their peak numbered over 100,000 troops. But they fought against everyone. In late 1919, they attacked Anton Denikin and the White Army, and in weeks took all of southern Ukraine. So Denikin brought in more troops from the north to drive out the Black Army, but this left him vulnerable to the Red Army from the north, who hammered him in the Caucasus toward the end of the year. It is quite likely that if the Black Army had not ruined Denikin's supply lines, the White Army would have taken Moscow in 1919. The Red Army then turned on Makhno and the Blacks, not needing them once Denikin's whites were beaten, and launched loads of attacks against them and any sympathizers, as well as trying to have Makhno assassinated. And with their superior numbers, they took back great areas of Russia that were under anarchist control. Soon enough, though, Leon Trotsky, the commander of the Red Army, had ordered terror tactics against Ukrainian villages supposedly loyal to Makhno. But when Red Army units were then withdrawn, Tsarist Cossacks and more White Army under Pyotr Wrangel again overran southern Ukraine until the blacks beat the pants off them. Trotsky offered another alliance to Makhno, who accepted. The Black Army then began clearing Ukraine of Cossack cavalry and Wrangel's remaining infantry, and his last men were evacuated from Sevastopol by the British in November 1920. 2 weeks after this, Makhno's staff and some Black Army commanders went to the Red Army's southern headquarters for a planning session. The Reds arrested and executed them by firing squad. They then sent hundreds of thousands of men with artillery, aircraft, and armored cars to destroy what was left of the Blacks, who were down to around 10,000 men or so after all this fighting. They succeeded in doing this, and Makhno and 77 of his men crossed into Romania in August 1921. This is just the tip of the iceberg, and you should really look this stuff up. It's amazingly complicated and amazingly interesting. And as for the Greens, well, that will have to be an answer for another day. I mentioned armored cars. There were also armored trains used a lot in the Russian Civil War. And if you'd like to see our special about armored trains, you can click right here for that. You can also check out our Twitter and check out our subreddit and learn all kinds of fascinating new things about the First World War. See you next time.